viewers, in this video, I'm going to show you a really cool product, the Measy Gyroscope Air Mouse Keyboard. This is model RC11. We did a previous one on the RC12. This one's special, uses a gyroscope to control mouse movements. Like its cousin, it supports a 2.4 gigahertz wireless signal, which you use this USB receiver for. It supports Android and a bunch of Windows operating systems. It's meant for smart TVs, and it works on PCs, notebooks, and Android TV applications. And it specifically shows you on the side it's RC11 model. And in the back, it just gives you your usual information about the features of the mouse. Cool thing is it supports a number of operating systems from Windows 98 to Windows 7, Linux operating systems, and Android. So in this video, we're going to do an unboxing and follow up with a test, show you how to use the Air Mouse keyboard. As we open it up, see it comes in the usual bubble wrap and it's well protected. Looks really nice, and has a manual, which we probably won't need to look at, so we'll just put that aside. And if you look at the keyboard, it looks really nice in terms of size. Feels like a typical TV remote. And let's pop the cover off. We're gonna add some batteries to this. It uses AAA batteries. The negative terminal side is here and the positive is here. Then we take the USB receiver off. Looks nice. We can either stick it in there or let me just take this thing out as we're going to be using it for the demo. Let me pop some batteries inside, and we're going to be using alkaline so that they last a long time. And with these, the gyroscope is a little different in that it will use send a continuous signal. So it's good to use alkaline batteries to give you a longer life. Snaps right on. So, and as you see, after powering it up, the light comes on immediately, which indicates that it's ready to transmitting to the receiver, and has a bunch of mouse buttons, left and right mouse buttons. Feels very lightweight, even the batteries are on. Alright, so now we have this USB receiver connected to our Android TV box, and let me introduce you to the RC11. If you look over here, you can see that there's the blue LEDs again that's currently off when the device is not sending a signal. There's the green Android button, which activates the gyroscope, and along with the left and right mouse buttons. A bunch of buttons on the top, which I'll describe in a moment. If you hit the green button in the center, which activates the gyroscope mode, the blue light lights up. And if you start moving the gyroscope mouse, you can see the mouse pointer moving up as you move the RC11 up, move it to the right, it goes to the right, it moves to the left as you move to the left, and obviously down if you want to try down. So really, you do not need a keyboard or a mouse on a desk to actually use this device. You can truly use it in the air, and that's why it's considered an air mouse. You could think of it as a laser pointer. Let me click the apps and hit settings. It'll tell you how you can actually control the speed of the mouse pointer movements. If you scroll down, and there's an option called language and input. If you scroll down to the bottom, there's a setting for pointer speed. You click the pointer speed, you can control by increasing or reducing the speed of the mouse movements based on your movements of the gyroscope air mouse. So this is pretty cool. I mean, it's a different kind of experience. You could be waving this on your sofa far away from your Android TV box. You don't need a cable or wire of any kind to connect to your device. Let's play a game to demonstrate how you can actually play games. This is one of the Ice Age Village games from Gameloft. And it's just a demonstration that shows you can actually play games with this device without having any elaborate touch screen. So really convenient. Looks like there's a pop-up screen here. Not sure where I should be clicking. I think if I click over here, it goes away. And in this game, I guess you can click any number of things. And if we click there, we have an option to let's go. We're building a sloth family. Pretty cool. You can navigate, play the game, and click things again with no wired connection to your Android TV. So really, really nice. And of course, you can always move left, right, all over the place, point, and convenience of doing this all of your single hand. You don't need, if you are using a touchpad, you need one hand to hold the touchpad and one to move. So this you can all do with a single hand. Now, there are a lot of other buttons also on this keyboard, in addition to your regular keyboard buttons, which it won't describe. But for example, if we look on the top row, there's this button over here. And if you see the home button, you press the home button, we get the Google home screen again. And if say you want to try this music button, and it brings up the music list, which you can use to control music. So the buttons are very useful. There's a mute button here. And there's also the low reducing volume low button. And actually, the Android device responds to all these button presses. So you can actually control a lot of things with the nice buttons. And what would be a really useful button here is the power down button. And it is the little reddish button over here. A lot of people may not know, but the button is supported even if you don't see the button. If you hold the button down for a few seconds, like on a normal typical PC, it brings up the power off screen. You can actually say power off your Android TV before pulling the power on it or something. In this case, we won't be doing it. So, but it's good to know all these features are available if you were using the RC11. Your regular keyboard buttons are pretty much what you would expect. And key difference is you have that gyroscope, and then you also have the cursor keys if you need to use it. Alright, so don't forget to subscribe, because we'll be covering more Android TV gear. You don't want to miss it. If you enjoyed this video, please tap the thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.